Hey, yo, what is up? What is up, ladies and gentlemen? We are going to be talking about the fight that happened yesterday. Queen, the monster, Naoya Inoue versus cool boy Steph Fulton. And this fight is, it was a big fight, anticipated fight between these two. We have Inoue, a three-division world champion, former undisputed at 118, stepping up in weight, fighting the best in the division, in Stephen Fulton, who was unified and had two belts at 122 at bantamweight. And I'm telling you now, Inoue is the real deal. A lot of people before this fight had this 50-50, and a lot of people were saying, that Fulton was going to KO Inoue in the later rounds. And a lot of people were saying that he was going to beat Inoue, either KOing or on decision. But they were so wrong. Inoue just showed his skill, his class, and he showed Fulton that he's levels above, man. He did show his levels above. He was just amazing. Stephen Fulton had no control of this fight at all. Inoue had the control of this fight from round first to the eighth, where the KO happened, man. He had this shit under control at all times. Oh boy, dog. The monster. He still had his power. He was faster than Fulton. He was stronger than Fulton. He showed the IQ was higher than Stephen Fulton. He just overall showed that he's a better fighter. And showed why Naoya Inoue is regarded as a pound-for-pound fighter. And why he is where he's at, man. He showed a lot of doubters. There was a lot of doubters out there who were saying that Naoya Inoue hasn't fought anybody. And that his biggest fight was against a 40-year-old Donaire. And there were just a lot of doubters out there, but dude, he proved, man. Not only that, he proved a lot of allegations. There were a lot of allegations thrown against Inoue out there. They were saying that Inoue was, he was on PEDs. They were saying that Inoue was double stacking on his hand wraps to make it, to make him like his punches stronger, which is completely false, man. The reason that thing, What they do is legal in Japan, double stacking, and it is not to generate power. It is to help Inoue protect his hands more so he won't break his hands, man. That's all it is. But you know, people don't really know that much, so they just wanna talk nonsense. Stephen Fulton's team was in the locker room looking at how they were hand wrapping Inoue's hands. And they were hand wrapping Inoue's hands exactly how Fulton's team wanted it to, you know. And he still knocked them out, bro. It just showed the class and the level of Inoue. He showed why he's such a special fighter and a one generational talent, man. And the fact that they're already putting him against Tank Davis, people really want Inoue to go up two more divisions and fight Tank Davis. Like, what the f-? That's how good Inoue is, bro. That you want Tank Davis to fight him. But we'll see. He'll get there. He'll eventually get at 130 pounds. I think that might be his limit in terms of divisions on Inoue, because he's such a talented fighter. I do think he'll clean up the 122, and he'll clean up the 126 easy. And but the 130 is going to be a little of a challenge, but not that much for Inoue. But we'll see, for what we've seen, because he's not only, he doesn't have only punching power, he has IQ. He has just, he's a great boxer, bro. He's not just a puncher, bro. He's a great, great boxer. He's a beast. Naoya Inoue, he could be like the next Manny Pacquiao in terms of going up divisions and conquering different divisions. He could probably could conquer 6 divisions if he wants to. Because he has the goods, man. He has the goods. Speed, footwork, power, IQ, you name it. The jab, bro. His jab is beautiful. Then that jab to the body. He kept hitting Stephen Fulton to that jab to the body and then to the rope and then to the overhand right. That 1-2, he kept throwing that throughout the fight, setting it up, and eventually it caught Stephen Fulton. That was a brutal, brutal knockout, bro. It was a clean, accurate. He has accuracy, bro. That's one thing about Inoue. He has accuracy. Right? He has accuracy, brother. He's so precise with his punches. He knows where to attack. He knows where to attack. You know what I'm saying? That's what I love about Inoue. That's what makes him great. What would be next for him? What's next for Inoue, man? What is next for Inoue is Inoue needs to go over there and fight. Now Inoue has to unify the division and become a 2-time undisputed champion in less than 6 fights. Amazing from now, yeah, Inoue. And after that, go to 126 because there's going to be no one left at 122. He clearly is going to clear both 2 of the best at 122, and then he's going to go to 126. Either fight, oh, of course, Robeasy Ramirez, if he still ends up, you know, retaining his titles, or, you know, Venado Lopez, or anybody in there. He could just go on, and I do think he could clean up that division, man. Robeasy is a good fighter, man, but, you know, it's just, I'm telling you, he is a generational talent. Robeasy is a great, great fighter, bro, but there is levels, and Inoue is just that level above. But yeah, that'll be it, man. Stephen Fulton, a lot of people are saying that Stephen Fulton, you know, he would look, that power of Inoue got to Stephen Fulton, and it made him respect Naoya Inoue a lot. He went up there, he fought the best, he tried, he traveled, and a lot of fighters don't do that. A lot of fighters from American fighters don't travel across seas to fight, and he did it, man. He earned a big payday, and he's still one of the best fighters out there. Stephen Fulton, he could go to 126 and conquer. He could actually get some titles there. Some yeah, man. There you go. Thank you all for watching, and Inoue the monster once again, pound for pound number one. Spence and Crawford need to do something special. Alright. Spence. I think if Spence beats Crawford, I don't think that'll be enough to get him to number one pound for pound for me. Because pound for pound, you gotta conquer other divisions. And other weight divisions. And Spence still hasn't done that yet. Crawford has already done that yet. Already 3 times, I think. He started at 135. He went to 140. And then 147. And if he becomes undisputed and beats him, then he will be pound for pound number one. But he needs to make it in a devastating fashion, how Naoya Inoue did it against Stephen Fulton. He needs to outbox, outshine. He needs to outbox and outshine Errol Spence Jr. and then knock him out, bro, in order for him to be number one and put his name, stamp his name at number one. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hope you guys enjoyed this video. And yeah, man, comment and subscribe. Let me know, guys, what you think about Naoya Inoue, the monster, the beast himself. And yeah, man, peace.